Hi, young explorers! Wonder Playland here. Have you ever seen the sky dance with colors? Today, we're going on a journey to discover the magical lights known as the Aurora Borealis and Aurora Australis. And guess what? Our friend Toby is going to join us on this journey and help us learn about the aurora. The magical lights of the auroras have special names. Near the North Pole, they're called the Northern Lights, or Aurora Borealis. Near the South Pole, they're called the Southern Lights, or Aurora Australis. But what causes these auroras? Well, it all begins with the sun. The sun does more than just give us light and warmth. It also sends a lot of energy and little particles our way. Most of the time, these particles are blocked by Earth's shield, or what is known as a magnetic field. However, sometimes there are powerful solar storms where the sun lets out a huge burst of energy that can travel to Earth at fast speeds. These particles of energy reach Earth and travel down the magnetic field lines towards the North and South Poles. Then, these particles join together with gases in our atmosphere. The gases can't keep this energy all to themselves, and they release it into the sky as beautiful displays of light. Oxygen gives off green and red light. Nitrogen glows blue and purple. Where are some great places on Earth to see these auroras? Well, the closer you are to either the northern or southern poles, the chances of seeing auroras during solar storms are going to be higher. For the northern lights, try visiting one of these amazing places: Alaska, Iceland, Canada, Norway, Finland, and Sweden. But just so you know, sometimes the northern lights can be seen even further south than these places, sometimes even as far south as Florida. For the southern lights, try visiting one of these places: Antarctica, Tasmania, New Zealand, and Australia. The southern lights are not as easily visible as the northern lights, but still are amazing to see. Did you know that auroras aren't just visible on Earth? Planets like Saturn and Jupiter have their own stunning light displays, thanks to their atmospheres and magnetic fields. A planet has to have both in order to have the chance for auroras. Have you ever seen the northern lights? Well, whether you've seen them or not, we hope you get to experience the dance of the auroras someday soon. They remind us of the endless wonders our universe holds. Thanks for learning about the auroras with us today, kids. Until our next adventure, keep looking up and wondering about the mysteries of our beautiful planet and beyond. Goodbye, young explorers!